fin préparé tout bagay pour maman tal vann et puis pendant les trois besoin troisième retira du moi pour me bien dans cala et puis cala vinn souké ensemble avec moi couri moi prend une nièce moi qui était dans cala moi voyer le dehors et puis moi sorti à vinn tomber et puis cala vinn tomber sous moi kay trois étages et tombé sous point moi ensuite m'rété m'bazé m'jwenn moun retiré comme fait 11h du soir en bas là c'est coupé moi mandé couteau moi coupé m'sorti après 3 jours m'en mal l'hôpital avec me coupé l'aime levé dans cabane moi le matin juste pas fin d'autre moi t'ai demandé checker monde qui ca aider pour manger pour me laver et tout pour font ta des bagages c'est monde moi toujours qui aider dans système ça qui toujours longer dans mes bras moi avec petite moi parce que nous pas gain moi nous pas ca vivre et moi pas ca travailler je sais monde qui toujours à soutenir
So what we're doing here in Haiti is running one of the largest ever 3D printing workshops in a developing country. And it's very exciting because now we've trained locals in Haiti to be able to produce low-cost, high-functioning prosthetic devices. They're going to be able to distribute to people in need that are in their community.
And then you'll need to hit OK.
The mere fact that we're teaching 3D printing to a group of prosthetists, that's never been done anywhere in the world.
Using the Ultimaker printers, that's going to allow them to print sockets and print whole forearm systems.
It makes sense here because like in the US, you know, like the sockets are made out of carbon fiber. Why would you 3D print a plastic one when you can get something out of carbon fiber? But here, by, you know, the plastic greatly reduces the costs. And also greatly reduces the expertise needed.
Je suis orthoprothésiste catégorie 2 et technicienne en réhabilitation physique et de fauteuil roulant. Parce que quand on m'a expliqué qu'on allait pouvoir scanner des prothèses et surtout nos propres pièces, j'étais vraiment excitée. Donc, quand j'ai entendu parler de cette formation, j'ai dit, pas de problème, quel que soit le jour où ça va arriver, ben, je dois voir ça. Voilà.
Over the last couple of days, they've really started to grasp it. And every single day, they're starting to think of different possibilities that they can use the 3D printers for. And that's the most rewarding thing, is realizing, you know, what we're showing them is a slice of the pie. And these 3D printers have so much more capabilities than that. You know, you give someone a tool, and they're going to figure out unique ways to use that tool.
Pour commencer, je dois dire que cette technologie est la bienvenue en Haïti. Vu son accessibilité en matière de prix, en matière de chaussage, c'est facile. Donc, savoir qu'on peut offrir ça à toutes les bourses et à tous les patients qui en ont besoin, déjà, ça facilite la vie.
Someone who loses a limb, you know, I mean, they go through a dramatic feeling of loss. You know, I mean, they sort of go, you know, go through the stages of grief.
Puis depuis tout, je suis dans la zone, je suis venu ici, je n'ai pas de monde qui veut jouer sur moi. C'est moi avec petit moi là, nous dormons là. Je n'ai pas de côté, mais c'est pas trop normal pour moi parce que déjà dommage. J'aime bien un côté qui assure qui me caresse.
You know, of anyone I know, she needs help. And she certainly has to deal with some stigma issues because she doesn't have an arm. in her kind of a community, I guess asking someone else to wash your clothes for you is sort of not really accepted. That's one thing that we really want to give her, is the ability to wash her own clothes.
So the device that Jeff provided with one of the patients here was very experimental. It was a transhumeral device that was really the first of its kind. It was a fully 3D printed forearm and hand. Mostly it was cosmetic. It did have some small function with the bending of the thumb for the patient to grab small objects.
Give it a shot.
We're seeing very quickly with 3D printing and the ability to design a lot of these components, and adding on to them and making them better for the patient, lighter, more cost effective, just better looking in general too. Having the ability to produce a natural skin tone, all of these things play into trying to get the best device to the patient.
I'm happy. I'm very happy. I think we got it. So here, feel the weight.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. I want you to put it on. You know, we had that moment with Danny, yesterday where she puts it on and she's like, I would actually wear this. And that is the moment that I'm going to go away with. Okay. Now grab here.
Stop.
Yep.
We did actually. We had a ditching.
Pull. There you go. And then you can just put that down right there. And just be like, for her to realize that, wait a second, this could be what I've been wanting it to be. Those are the powerful moments that stay with me. That was really, really good for the first time.
No, sans qu'à utiliser m'ka laver avec et tout m'ka mettre dessus moi. N'est-ce pas? M'ka mettre dessus moi. Quand pile bagay sorti.
Merci.
Pour Dani, c'est sa première prothèse. Elle est contente. Elle est contente. Pour plusieurs raisons. Elle me dit, là, je peux aller à l'église. Elle peut prendre soin de ses enfants, de préparer à manger, de laver, parce que sa main est un peu fonctionnelle. La joie de mes patients fait ma joie. Ça, c'est ma force et c'est ce qui me motive d'apprendre plus, de continuer, de travailler. Sur tout ce que j'ai fait pour continuer à avoir encore beaucoup plus de joie. Et je crois que ça va me permettre de vivre assez longtemps. Oui. Donc voilà.
I'm learning right along with the other students how to best implement these devices. I've learned a lot about what these devices can and cannot do. And that just makes me want to strive further for trying to better the designs and seeing how we can best give the patients what they want.
If someone wants a device, they shouldn't be limited just because of the country they're in or how much money they have. They should be able to have access to it. And I think with 3D printing, because the technology is so flexible, because it's so versatile, I think people that wouldn't have the money could then afford it. And people that maybe wouldn't have accessibility, now you can just bring maybe a 3D printer to their location and you can print one for them. So it increases that capacity to deliver prosthetics to people that they actually want.